18th Sunday of Ordinary Time, Year B. Jesus, the food of our life. You may remember that last week's Gospel passage ended with the crowd's enthusiasm who wanted to proclaim Jesus as King. And we can say that Jesus was at the height of human success. But still for him, it was the greatest disappointment. He had realized that he has not been able to make the people understand the meaning of the sign he had given. He had taken the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 fish, that is all that the people had at their disposal, and had shown that this food was not only enough to feed everyone, but it was simply superabundant. He had given a sign that the people did not understand. The people considered Jesus as a miracle worker. And unfortunately, this is the misunderstanding that we also fall into. The Gospel says, when the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here? When did you get here?" The passage was written for us, you see. We also need today clarification to understand well what Jesus comes to do in our lives. We must identify ourselves in these multitudes of Capernaum with the disciples, the people, with all their expectations, because these are our expectations as well. This is what we expect from Jesus today. When did you come here? And this is not the question they wanted to ask him. What they have in mind is something else, and it is this: Jesus, will you do wonders for us to make our life easier in the world? When we have problems and difficulties, you see, Jesus, you have to solve them with miracles, because if you do not help us in these concrete things, in these material needs that we have, what is the use of having known you? What is the use of prayer? You see, these expectations of the people of Capernaum are not very different from those of many Christians today. We also have heard expressions very similar to those of the inhabitants of the people of Capernaum. You know, I have heard this, for example, many times. You know, it goes like that: "I am a believer. I'm a Catholic. I'm a Christian. But if I am in need because I have problems and I call the Lord and he does not intervene, what is the use of believing?" And these are the same objections that the people of Capernaum raised to Jesus. They only expect him to intervene to help them in their material needs. So let us face it. We all have challenges and difficulties, and we all of us have asked God for help in our lives, right? So let us talk a little bit about the challenges that we have and our faith. For a believer, difficulties are always overcome. Everything is overcome with God's help. But for that we need to pray well, because we alone can do nothing. So it is the power of prayer and also human collaboration. God puts in almost everything. You put in almost nothing. But God does not put his almost everything if you do not put your almost nothing. Last Sunday, the young boy put 5 loaves and 2 fish. That was all. He put very little. And Jesus put almost everything. And this is for all our needs. We ask God. You know, he's at your side. He's closer to you than your own breath. And if he doesn't work out the way you wanted it to, have faith that that is better for you. God knows better than you. If God does not give you what you ask for, it's because it doesn't suit you. And how many times things don't work out the way we want, and then we say, thank goodness it didn't work out the way I wanted, because it was better this way. There is a Jesuit, Spanish Jesuit, who was just canonized by Pope Francis. It's Father Rubio. And he has a sentence that is the secret of happiness. And it is this: do what God wants and want what God does. Let's say that again. Do what God wants and want what God does. If you want what God does, you remain always calm. But you insist that God should listen to you, but God knows much more than you do. Let God do what is convenient for you. You ask for what you think is convenient. Of course, this is common sense. But if God doesn't do it, you know, I'm happy as if God has given it. What have I asked for? Because I want what God does. It is not what I wanted, but now I want what God does. And I always come out a winner. Okay, this is Father Rubio's secret. You know, it was actually his motto: do what God wants and want what God does. Would be nice if you can write it down and keep it on your desk, on your wallet, you know, and look at it once in a while. Back to the gospel of today. The only bread that satisfies the need for complete joy is the word of Jesus, is the word of Christ, is the gospel. It's not the manna of the wilderness. And until you find this bread that satisfies, you will always be restless, even if you fill yourself with all the goods of this world. For, let's face it, they are all perishing goods. May God bless you.